boss grandmother. Tip a shot of all that. Pipe your kiddo, honey. Tell your man to chill. Or else you'll be your widow. Did not you know that my style's a top dollar? The 5 foot assassin, I can fleas off his collar. Hip hop scholar, since being the hot to a duck. The hide of Muggsy Bones. Complexion of a hockey puck. You better ask somebody on how we flip the script. Come to a tribe show and watch the three kids rip. Krazees in the house. Represent, represent, zen. A tribe called Quest.
Represent, represent.
No teaming up the scale because it gets a red print. A tribe called Quest. Represent, represent, zen.
There we go. Don't be afraid to shake it. Put your dance face on. It's a little dark. There we go. Light it up a little bit. I just came to bring some chatterings. Bring some chatterings to you. If you haven't been up on all things, that is M&E and Twiztid. And Paul. I've been up to some shit, man. What, Ashton? Anywho, we've been talking about this thing called NetFest. It's the biggest free preview you've ever heard of. And it's May 30th. And let's let a joint talk about it. Paul is good, Shay. So I'm going to be traveling amongst all the social media outlets here and there, reminding everybody to mark May 30th on your calendar. Get ready. Free. Astronomicon's YouTube. While you're here, I don't know if you can do it now, but just go subscribe to Astro's YouTube so you don't got to do that when it happens. But it's going to be hours. This ain't going to be like a fucking 20-minute Twiztid bit. This shit is, it's going to be a night. And it's the best thing we can do right now for you guys. What time's it going to start? We'll let you know, because it's, there's the pre-show and then there's the show. It's all, this is a fucking deal, bro and broette. And I'm telling you guys, man, when you see all the people fucking associated with it, that's a part of this, it's going to make you rethink some things. You had snow yesterday, Montana. I hear it, Josh. Me and Madrox been going live here and there. Just chatterings. Just minimal chatterings. So NetFest is going to be a concert. Headlined by us and the one and only Blazer Den homie. But supported and other people that will be performing and presenting things. It's fucking nuts. It's like the goddamn underground Grammys. I can't even say the underground. It's just like a fucking, like an award ceremony, but there is no award. The award is you guys have won it just for being the shit. You guys get this. So we've been vigorously going at this thing. That's what she said. Yep, I'll tell you that. Boondocks will also be a part of it. I'm telling you, man, you guys have no clue. Your friends, you tell them, God damn it, NetFest is coming, and it's May 30th, and I know ain't nobody got shit to do. Nobody got shit to do. Everybody's home, so it's the perfect time. Perfect. Perfect. put it like this. We don't ask for shit from nobody. From nobody. And this, for you guys, we fucking went to everybody. Everybody. And the response has just been, I'm just through the roof, man. So you'll be able to sit on your couch, go to Astro's YouTube, and be entertained for a few hours. Who do you guys thinking of? Go ahead, say a name. Say a fucking name. I bet we went after him. Obama? Yep. Yep, we're gonna smoke. We're smoking together. That's how we're gonna start that bitch when we hit the stage. I'm gonna be like, wait! Everybody get your joint. We're gonna light that motherfucker up together. And then me and Madrox are gonna rock your faces off for a little bit. What channel? Astronomicon's YouTube. I'm trying to draw traffic there, you know what I mean? We could have did it on the Twiztid one, but fuck it. It's got to grow. And what a great way to draw attention to Astro. King Gordy, I see Gordy coming up. Motherfucking Gordy in the bitch. Gordy's got top five greatest voices ever. Like, that guy's voice is just fucking magic. I just want Gordy to read me bedtime stories when I'm going to sleep. Now, this is what you're going to do. Like, I can't even do it. Like, he's got almost like an 840-ness to him. Army with harmony. King ISO. Shouts out to ISO. Val Astro was off the chains, right? Astro was such a blast, man. That's goddamn. I just wanted to choke. Some people told us no. Some people were like, no. Fuck y'all. What was the funniest interview we ever did? That's some shit I don't pay attention to. I fucking hate doing interviews. I hate doing interviews. It's the same questions over and over again. Motherfuckers ain't, we're not big enough for them to really do any fucking work and make it interesting, so it's always 9 out of 10 times is just bullshit. I hate doing that shit. We did some good ones on Warped Tour. That was fun. Yeah, fucking 6ix9ine had 2 million viewers on his fucking motherfucking told on everybody. Had 2 million viewers. We'll see what NetFest does. I don't even know what you would have to do to get 2 million people to watch. I don't even know. What's the craziest thing a groupie has ever done to get backstage to meet you? Shit, I don't know. They're already back there. It ain't like we're like, okay, now what'd you do to get back? Now it's, oh, man. I watched this shit today. I found out it's older and it's on Amazon Prime. And the shit is called The Wonderful Whites of West Virginia. And fucking Johnny Knoxville did it. Holy shit. That was an entertaining hour and a half. That I at the end of it, my mouth was on the floor. Any of you guys ever heard of that? I'm waiting. No, I watched this, enjoyed it. Is that the one with Kathy Bates in it? It was not good, if that's it. I watched like the first episode or two. Johnny Knoxville's fucking shit, man. The Wonderful Whites of West Virginia have a YouTube? See? I'm so far behind. I just caught up, y'all. And I'm telling you guys, if you ain't watching, watch that shit. That shit is... Who's on NetFest? We're on it. Fucking Blaze is on it. Boondocks is on it. Touchdown, I ain't got nothing to tell you about that shit. I don't know what to tell you. I know, I can't wait for the virus to be over either. But we're going to do what we can do. Am I still making beats? Yep, I made the first beat for my solo record. The first song I wrote is to a beat I did. It came out dope. I just bought like 40 pops in the last 2 days. If you wear a mask when you go out, raise your hand. Give me a hand up. Let me see it. Where's the MNE COVID mask? I don't know, man. I don't know. So you guys are all doing your part. You're wearing your fucking mask. I wear that bitch. I ain't trying to hear nobody's mouth. I want to sock nobody up or get socked up. Because you never know. Everybody know MMA now. Everybody can fight now. Yeah, absolutely. I wear a mask. Val said, nope. The world needs to see that face. All of it. You know me, I've been looking for an excuse to cover this motherfucking face. I'm like, hell yeah, I wish they made you wear like an entire facial cover. Like we had to wear some motherfucking hijabs or something in this motherfucker. I'm like, hell yeah, whatever it takes. Or you gotta wear a hood and scrunch that bitch up till only like the little bit of your face comes out. Wear your Olive Sulu mask, yep. Run in a Kroger with a fucking AXE mask on. There you go. That'll make getting your... That'll get your range for, what is it, free range individually wrapped chicken breast or your Laura's lean beef. That'll make it interesting. Warrior spiritual, above the clouds raining down, holding it down. Above the What kind of car am I in? I'm in a 93 Ford Focus. Four-door, but only two doors work. You said I'm looking thin. I just weighed my chubby self. I was a svelte 205. Although I did have my shoes on, and my shoes be making me chubby. And I was like, dang, too, I ain't bad. That's about where I've been for, like, right around that. I think I was up to, like, 211 for a little bit. I don't eat like that, though. Mini Monoxide, it ain't no hoopty. All right, yeah, it is. Blame it on shoes, man. That's what it be, man. I stepped on the scale. It took me over 200. I was like, all right. It might be time to figure some things out. I see my man Matthew getting it together. I see my motherfucking homie Matthew getting it together. I'm like, maybe I need to do something. Will Smith said the only Ford you catch him in is a Mustang. I don't give a fuck. I don't care about cars and shit like that. Don't matter to me. You know why I think I don't care about? Because I never needed that shit to get anything I needed to get. You know what I mean? Not like I got a lot of shit, but like talking to girls, I ain't never need no fancy ass car or dumb jewelry or none of that shit. I was broke as shit. Broke as a bitch. I was pulling everybody. It didn't matter. Just some shit I don't really give a fuck about. It could be a Corvette. Don't matter to me. I don't even care if it runs good. That bitch can break down, I'll call an Uber. It makes no sense, I know. That's why it makes sense. Anyway. Which one of you motherfuckers saw that movie called The Lodge? I need to see a hand again. Because we didn't really get... We talk about it on Facebook a little bit. Like, we went into movies on Facebook, y'all. Because I've seen all kinds of shit. My range of movies is quite vast. I just don't watch a lot of dumb shit. Like, I don't give movies longer than 20, 25 minutes. If you ain't got me by then, off. You seen The Lodge? I'm telling you. That was a good one, y'all. That was worthy. Did I watch a new Harlequin movie? No. I don't really like that character, though. I don't think I will see it. I'm telling you, Kara, go watch that shit tonight. You might have to watch something else after it, just so, you know, you can unscramble. Like, what? Good acting. Excellent acting. That's what I loved about it. Yeah, Necromonster, I'm not going to say that, but I didn't know what to think. I didn't know. Even at the end, I was like, what the fuck just happened? The Last Kingdom? What is that one? I started watching one of them. Harley Quinn, the character is the shit, but I don't know. I just don't like DC movies, man. I don't. And I've watched enough of them before I can finally be like, you know what? You just don't like DC. You don't like the writing. You don't like the way they shoot. You don't like their editing. None of it. I just don't like it.
twice. Smash the Gilligan boat with ice.
They threw sign language.
Ordered hot coffee with a Danish. Relax, whispered they rap entertainers.
Had Lizzie on two jacks.
I watched a little bit of Viking. It just got lost in the sauce.
We too black for BT. You memorized the one to 40.
I'm at the 19th degree. If it's civilized
first. Yeah, I watched shit out that Marvel shit.
Pardon me, God. That nigga got a gun poking out his sweatpants. Check out his stance. See the side of his grill?
Look like my cousin Lance. Left hand. Rocky chest.
Yo, I think I did his cross. You want a crush ball?
Man, we probably ain't gonna get Quiet Place 2 this year. That sucks. I hope we do, because that trailer looks gangsta.
Keep your eye on that same nigga from right here. Popcorn spilling all on Liz Claiborne Ghost. Had to fly Gucci Mox with no socks on. Seen Deion Sanders in the back.
All right, who's already subscribed to Astronomicon's fucking YouTube? Subscribe. Show me some hands. Who's my favorite Marvel character? I really don't know. Not one of them has really jumped out. You know who I like? And this is going to sound crazy, because I can never remember his name. All right. You know, in the Thor movies, when he gets locked up before, when Jeff Goldblum's got Thor locked up and he's talking to that stone dude, him and Meek, you're alive. That dude's dope. I don't know, man. If you're just like, hey, no, you got to pick one, then I'm picking Deadpool. I'd say he's my favorite. You wanted to put the gun in my head? You put the ball in my court? I picked Deadpool. Extraction. No, but I'm hearing about that one. Like, the last few days, I've been hearing about Extraction. I started watching another one. I'm so bad with the goddamn titles. I believe it's called All in a Day or A Day in a Night. Some shit like that. Like some new hood shit. Give it up for Frank Castle. Hey, number two is probably Daredevil. Like, Daredevil, that's that motherfucker. But Punisher, shout out to Punisher. But I seen something crazy. That skull that's on Punisher's chest, look up a whale skull. It looks the same. I don't know the lore. You guys might be like, oh, bitch, that's what it is. But I ain't gonna be too many more bitches. I don't watch anime at all. Daredevil's coming back. Did you hear that? That shit's coming back. Season 4. But it might not be on Netflix. I don't give a fuck where they put that shit at. I'll be there. I'm going to check Extraction out tonight, then. No, not even DBZ, bro. My brothers watch that shit. My kids watch it. They are talking Hulu. That's what I thought. I didn't think it was going to be there. I didn't think it was going to be back on Netflix. I also heard that the fucking villain in the new Blade series is fucking Count Dracula. Like, that's gonna be dope. Like, God, man, Marvel just farting in everybody's face. Get you some, bitch. Get you some, bitch. Get you some. Yeah, Mandalorian was fucking awesome. Man, I don't know about Disney Plus, though. Super confusing as to what they should have and what they don't have and what they said they'd have. Like, I don't know, man. Oh, Blade 3 was terrible. No bullshit. Blade 1 wasn't much better, but Blade 2 was good. One of my favorites. There's a new Blade! You believe that shit? Yes. There's a new Blade. They got a new character. It ain't Wesley Snipes' weird ass anymore, I guess. Super Luke, you said Disney owns Hulu? Yeah, soundtrack to Blade 2 was dope. A lot of electronic. You know, a lot of that shit. It ain't a white dude playing Blade, bitch. Shut your ass up. It's your false propagandas. You want it to be a white man, and then you watch it, because you're probably a fucking racist. I don't know. I'm just attacking you. I'm sorry. It's the dude from season one, Luke Cage, who will play Blade. It ain't. It's Luke Cage? The guy that played Luke Cage? Or somebody from Luke Cage? Here we are. They said that Count Dracula wants to turn everybody into vampires and Blade ain't having it. So they battle it out. And who else? They said there's two more villains in it too. But I never fuck with the comics, so I don't know who they are. One is called Vampire Man or some type of shit. Something, Man of Vampire or Moon Knight. That's dope. That's supposed to be happening. But now I'm going to flip your wing. They said the third villain for Blade, but they're going to flip it and turn them on so they're on the same side at a point, is fucking Ghost Rider. Beep, beep, beep. Wah, 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 wah. Wah, 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 wah. Fucking Ghost Rider. And they said they're going after Keanu Reeves' weird ass to play him. That's tastiest fire you've ever seen, bro. Eat this. I'm sure he ain't gonna talk like that, but. But yeah. How dope is that Ghost Rider in this motherfucker? That right there peeled my wig off. I was like, oh shit! So keep your eyes out for that. That Blade shit's gonna be dope. Dope, dope, dope. It is part of the fucking Marvel Universe. Also, for fucking Daredevil, they said there was a couple people that were going to be in that shit, too. Constantine was dope. I liked that movie. I thought it was really good. Yeah, I'm excited, man. Oh, the villain from Luke Cage's Blade. Thank you, Super Luke. Freddy Krueger versus Michael Myers. Kind of seen it. I want somebody else to get the franchise, the Michael Myers franchise. Like us. I wish we had that kind of cheese or that kind of respect. Whether right, Keanu could ride the shit out that motorcycle. No, I haven't watched the MJ documentary. There ain't nothing on that documentary I want to hear. Nothing. He's the greatest. I don't give a fuck what Isaiah Thomas says. I don't give a fuck that he punched Steve Kerr in the face. I knew all that shit. They haven't said anything in that documentary that I did not already know. At least all the points that they're bringing up that they talk about it with. It was all shit everybody already knew. He still buy DVDs? Holy shit, bro. Man. I ain't mad at you. That's what makes you smile, homie. You smiling makes me smile, so. And that goes for each and every one of you motherfuckers. Short of it being something that kills you. Right, Keanu's into the motorcycle, so he'll be freaking that shit. Riding in on the front wheel. I'm cashing checks. Us two, you guys buy DVDs. A lot of people still buy them, or else you wouldn't see them. Just not a lot of people still buy them. That's why you don't see them that much. I got the messages to slow down, but it's still too fast for my high eyes. Yes, he does have his own bike shop. You are correct. Walmart $5 bid. You're paying way too much for DVDs, bro. You better hit them truck stops. Jamie be going in there like, look what I got for $3. KU, you didn't miss anything. This is merely just me traveling around, making sure I get to everybody on social medias. I'll be going to Instagram next, just letting everybody know. Mark that date on their calendar. Get your fucking babysitters if you can. Is there, I don't know. I had to go 3 places today. Same place twice to drop my daughter off, then pick her up, and then I stopped by Walgreens. All day long, you never know there was, the only reason you know that there's something going on because everybody got masks on. But motherfuckers are out. So I don't know, man. You probably can have people over your house. Everybody wearing masks or some dumb shit. I don't know. Whatever it takes. Long as it makes you smile, like I said. But mark the 30th on there. The free purview. Was I lying in the past life? No. What are you going to set me up? Like, well, because you be lying now, bitch. You ain't shit but a bitch. You lying ass bitch. I'm not a good liar, so I tend not to. You're a lion in the regular zodiac? I'm a Cancer. Any good stories? I got tons of stories. Tons of stories. Yeah, my story. I don't know how many of my stories you guys have heard. I've been doing these lives on Facebook, you guys, for a minute. We just talk. We just be gigging. Super Loops of Cancer. See, he's got my back. He's like, sure, we're passive about things, but once you cross that line, it is bad news. As nice as we are twice as mean. And that's one thing I don't see anybody say about cancers, but I know for a fucking fact. We love hard and we hate hard. When we hate, it's over with. When you get to that point where we're like, I fucking hate you. There is nothing, nobody that is, what do you call that? Safe from that. I don't give a fuck who you are. If you do something that gets me there, it's a done deal. It's a done deal. You're a Leo? Well, you just missed out. I'll tell you guys, fucking, this is crazy, right? This, my brother Jeremy and the homie Rob, right? Rob was that dude that this motherfucker got out of everything. Everything. I'm not bullshitting you. He'd get pulled over with a half a bird and not get no trouble. I'm not even bullshitting you. We're driving, right? This motherfucker's like, I can't believe something's too easy to do. He's like, look, we're about to ride by this house real quick, pick something up. I'm like, all right, let's go. Boom. Hit it, come back. We make the loop around, not the loop around, but to make the left and go the other way down 8 Mile, you had to come over right here. Right when we went there, got flicked. Pull us over. This motherfucker. This motherfucker's like, hey, look, I got an elbow under you. And I got 4 ounces of white in individual bags under me. I swear to God. I was like, bro, as soon as this motherfucker comes to your door, I'm busting. I'm out. He was like, no, man, just chill out. Just chill out. I swear to y'all on every fucking thing. Cop comes, ask this motherfucker for let me get your license and registration. He's like, I ain't got it. I'm like, oh, shit. I'm going for that motherfucking handle. And the dude's like, I'm not even bullshitting you. He's like, Rob? Oh, bop, bop, bop. Knew the motherfucker from high school, some dumb shit like that. We fucking pulled off. And we both had guns. Like, oh, God. Oh, I swear to God, man. Anyway, me, him, and my brother Jeremy, we're in this fucking, not a caravan. We were in a ragged, we used to call it the Beast. Rob had like a motherfucking 86 Ford F-150 that didn't even look like it should run. But anyway, we pull up in the driveway, right? We're all three just on that strip of cement that goes up to your porch, right? We had all three just made it on that. We lived on the corner. It's a four-way stop, right? So it's our house, cross the street. There's a house here, cross the street, house, cross the street, house. Going this way goes a 7 Mile. Goes this way goes to Gratiot. That means nothing to you guys, I know. But anyway, they were heading towards 70. This fucking caravan, slow as shit, right? Just, and we're like, what the fuck? And we're just watching it. It gets to like the halfway point of our house and the fucking van door whips open. What y'all looking at? Bop, 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 bop. Just start shooting without, and this is why, without fucking hesitation. Right into the house, grab it out the back door. Me, Rob, and Jeremy. Pop, 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 pop. Like, fucking nuts. And nothing happened. No cops never came. No nothing. Like, just out of fucking nowhere. That was my life from... basically, from the time I was 6 years old, till 23 was that. Like, the first memory, one of my first memories that I have from, we lived on another street called Wilfred, which was just off of Dickerson, which even deeper in the hood, right? Listen to this crazy shit. This was like back, let me think, like, this is crazy. I'm about to age it, but I don't give a fuck. This is like 79, right? Check this shit out. It was me and my brother Jeremy. I was probably like 6. He was like 4. He didn't turn 5 yet, but he was about to turn 5. It was that summer. His birthday was in that coming January. Down the street from us lived another bunch of kids. Snoopy, Keita. I remember their fucking names like it's nothing. Anyway, Keita was like 14 years old and a big ass girl, right? And they were in front of our house talking shit. I don't know what it was about, but that bitch scratched my brother from his neck. I mean, yank all the way down. And I was just like, oh, at that point in my life, I ain't never seen no shit like that. I was like, what the fuck just happened? And she just took off. My brother started crying. My mom comes out like, what the fuck is going on? He's bleeding. You know what I mean? Nothing crazy like that, but bleeding. You can see this shit coming through his fucking shirt. Like, oh, man. And so I tell the story, and my fucking dad hops into a car, speeds down there, right to the house. House was like 8 houses away. Pulled up in the driveway in the fucking 78 Grand Prix, and all you could hear was him yelling. You tell that fucking motherfucker she ever puts a hand up, blop, blop, bloop, blop, bloop, right? All that. Got back in the car, came back down. We're in the house now, and they're just telling us, you stay away from, don't even go down that way no more. Leave them motherfuckers alone, right? Well, like I said, all right, we ain't really know him like that anyway. We didn't really fuck with him like that. That's why we didn't expect no dumb shit like that. Anyway, about 15 minutes go past, right? I go out. I go down to my other people's house, Saban Taj. They had an older brother named Tony that we thought was the shit. He reminded me of motherfucking Nino Brown from New Jack City. No bullshit. At the birth of crack, too. Before the birth, this dude was crazy. Anyway, I'm talking to them, right? And all of a sudden, you hear this. My house was in the middle of this house was 2 houses from my house. All of a sudden, you heard it. You heard yelling, motherfucker, boom, 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 boom. And everybody was like, what the fuck? And by the time we came out from where we were standing on the side of the house in the driveway, we looked, all I seen was my dad with a shotgun, like father with a bead on this dude. And all of a sudden my mom grabbed it. Typical wife, no, get out the way. Which probably was for the best, because if he was a minster, whatever the fucking case. But that's what it was. Dude came down the street. Come to find out, dude came down the street, right? My mom and dad were standing out on the porch, and the guy was like, hey, weren't you the one down there just arguing with them people down there? And my dad was like, what the fuck's it to you? Right out the brown bag. Boom, boom, boom. Mom ran in the house. My dad ran in the house. My mom ducked. Dad kept going in the bedroom. Bullet. Right by my mom's head, like she got lucky as fuck. That shit was crazy than a bitch, though. Crazy. Crazy as shit. Next thing you know, we moved from there to Pinewood, to Seven and Grass. And we were there forever. And man, I'd have been in all kinds of shit, y'all. I'm telling you. All kinds of crazy shit. I remember another time we used to work all these fucked up jobs, right? Me, Jamie, my brother Jeremy, and Pickles. We all got a job at this fucking plastic factory, like out. It was like a 30-minute drive to work. So we all had to get jobs together so we could ride together because everybody ain't have cars. Anyway, we had probably been working there about 6 months. And I'm not bullshitting. You can ask Jamie the same shit. And we're doing our thing. We had the music bumping. This shit was bumping. Pickles was up on this fucking, like, motorized scaffold thing. 20 feet in the air, right? And all of a sudden, the manager, like, the people that give a fuck came in that bitch. Pickles was on top of that bitch like a stripper. Like, just fucking. The look on this dude's face when he looked at Pickles, I swear to God, I just better be like, oh, he's about to kill this dude right now. This motherfucker was just in his face with it, like, like he he ain't no clue who this motherfucker was. That shit. Oh my God. Ask Jamie. Ask Jamie about pickles dancing at the plastic factory. Oh shit. Oh, that shit was crazy. I'll tell you guys a funny story about Matt Nips. First time I met Matt Nips, Chris brought him over. Blaze, right? That's Blaze's cousin, his first cousin. So he brings him up. He's like, he's cool, man. He smokes weed. He's cool. So they showed up, and he was just this little chubby motherfucker. He was mad funny, right? And we go to smoke, and then everybody's talking about shotguns. Again, me with the fucking shotgun shit. So Matt Nip goes to, like, oh, look, I can do it the best. He does it, blows the blunt out of his mouth. Oh, shit. Right in my goddamn face. That's why I ain't got no eyebrows now, because this motherfucker had me all fucked up with the sparks and shit. But that was the first time I met Matt Nips. Like, Blaze, I swear to God, Chris thought I was going to kill him, but I'd already loved Matt. Already. Just from when I first met him, I loved him. I was like, that's my dude right there. So it didn't really make me mad like that, but they thought about this kind of shit. Y'all remember that? That was some bullshit. That was some shit. I was saving this one. I'm still saying, when you watch, you guys, wait. But we're all on the tour bus, right? At this point, we were touring 15 deep. There was motherfuckers sleeping on the couches. Like, when everybody went to bed, there was no place to hang out. Every area was covered in. So our merch guy got fucking annihilated. Annihilated. From Tamasu, 140, like that, done, right? So we put him in his bunk. The night starts to wear down. People start to go to their bunks. Now what you have is you have me, Jamie, Blaze, Pickles. Oh, I can't remember who else, but I want to say fucking ABK was there. And we're in the back of the bus smoking. All of a sudden, we seen McStumbly roll out of his bunk and go to the front of the bus. On the front of the bus, there's a couch on this side, there's a couch on this side, and a whole, like a pathway in the middle. On this side, Matt Nips is there. And Matt Nips is fucking out. Just doing what Matt Nips does, right? Out of the corner of my eye, I just pick up, like, that dude is standing there too long. Like, where he was, it didn't make any sense. He was standing, like, at the edge of the table, right at the beginning of the couch across from Matt Nips. And I just heard the weirdest fucking noise. And I'm like, hey, I won't put his name on blast. Hey, we'll just call him Samuel. Hey, Samuel, you good? This motherfucker turns around, and his little earthworm was hanging out, sprinkling piss all over that cop. Huh? Steady pissing. Immediately. I don't know why, but I was like, oh, shit, Matt Nips. Tommy was like, oh shit, we're all yelling, Matt Nips, get up. You're about to get pissed on. And the dude turned towards all of us and like started zombieing down the hallway after us, still pissing. We were like, ah! Motherfuckers were going crazy trying to close this door, man. Sure. Not even the scent of piss could get through that, right? So we got the door blocked. Nothing happened. We look back out. He's now standing directly in front of Matnip. Earthworm Jim, just a fucking dangling. Luckily, there was no piss coming up. And like a fucking soldier, Pickles trudged through that pissy carpet, hopped over a puddle of what could only be described as a viscous solution, and woke Matnips up, dragged him to the back safely. Nobody died, but you would have thought there was a fucking maniac with 12 inches of fucking steel butcher knives in both hands and razor blades on his knees, the way we were like, ah! When that motherfucker started coming down that hallway, he might as well have been walking on the ceiling. Like, that shit was crazy. I'll never forget that shit as long as I live. I'll never forget that shit long as I live. You can ask any one of the motherfuckers that I named in that story, and believe me, they ain't forgetting it either. Do I got any crazy ICB stories? I got all kinds of stories with them. But I don't know what they really want people to know, so I'm gonna just be telling shit. You know what I mean? Like, just I don't know what motherfuckers be wanting out there now these days. Motherfuckers got kids, their lives have changed. So just know that, yeah, we got in all kinds of shit with them dudes. Completely different life from my life from birth until I became a member of Twiztid, than from Twiztid to where I am right now. Two completely different lives. Completely different. Hey, if they tell stories about us, that's on them. I ain't think about them. I'm thinking about their kids. That is Master Ace. What you know about that? All right, I'll only take up like 2 more minutes of your time. If there's anything you guys want to ask me, fucking ask me. And then I'll wrap it up, let you go to bed. Check it out, y'all. I missed all the questions. They were fucking flying again. Wicked is coming to play next fest? No, we'll never do that again. It was an experiment. It was fun at times, but at the end of the day, nah. Killer Dams, you're about to get a fucking killer strain. How do we meet Blaze? We met Blaze through the ROC, because he used to record at Brian's studio. Do I have any Vanilla Ice stories? Yeah, I got 2 good Vanilla Ice stories. We'll talk about it next time I come on here. Remind me. Don't forget, remind me. Hey, tell us the Vanilla Ice stories. I got... I got 2 good ones. 2 good ones. And on that note, I love you motherfuckers. You know that. Go be great. Check it out. Yeah.